from the market. So I'm losing statements somehow. Anyway. So there is a strip service. So legacy codes kata. Wow, what does that mean? First of all, a coding kata is a practice that you do on some classic syntactic exercises designed to help learn several techniques. Then
there are
three major types of coding kata. Refactoring kata, that you start from some existing code with unit tests. There is the TDD kata, in which you start building software with tests. And there is also the legacy code kata. But when I say legacy, don't think of your own code. It is some classic example that is just, we will just solve this. We don't have tests, we don't have anything, just like life. And this is the production code that we will be handling. And we have the test here. As usual. Excellent.
Why?
It's there, just to be there in front of your eye, but it's empty. So, move, right, that's one. Okay, so we will try to create tests from this class. When we feel comfortable enough, we will be refactoring the class. Okay, so I will suppose, all right, let's just start. So let's create the first test. Let's name it D. Better. You could name it perfectly. Yeah? And then let's start writing some logic. The first thing you have to do is, so your task would be to refactor and clean this method get tips by users. Since you don't have unit tests, you could start writing tests. So let's suppose you want to call this method. To call this method, I need to first instantiate new trip service and then do get tips by user. And then provide a user, of course, null. Perfect. Just to invoke it, to see what happens. This thrill, throw yourself. Let's run the test and we should see the test, of course, failing. Why does it fail? Should be mocked away. What's this? Who threw this? But it appears that in this code, at some point, from get tricks by a user, I call the method get locked user. Do you know the name of this pattern? Or should I say anti-pattern? What's the name of this? Singleton. Because the instance of the user session currently active at one point, it kind of smells like thread data there, right? Do you sense the thread? Okay. But somehow it gets the current session and then gives you the user from the session. Good. But there is no session in the current, in the, of course, there is no HTTP server, so this will fail. This will fail. Because you can't possibly get the session inside the tests. What could you do? What can you do? There's an old ancient principle saying that when something annoys you, extract it. I will extract this line of code. I will take one hand and put it under my Control Alt M. Enter. Save moves. Not control backspace. I just extracted the method, which is now down below. Nothing can be broken by this move. Idea did it for me. And I will turn this into a public method. Do you suspect why?
In the test.
In the test, I will hack it. Meaning that, folks, here, I will put. Oh, exactly. But just bear with me. And then say G. This is the closest thing you can get to a hacking, right? This is like CURL.
This is the wrong method.
Wrong method? Right. Wrong. That's good, thank you. More program. Return, of course, null. Thank you. And then, we will make no assumptions, right? And then we'll see what happens. User not logged in. Who threw this? Oh, correct. Why? Because, wait a second, what happened here? Did you notice? We did not even read the code. We just built that. This is the life, right? Life. You just hit your head. Okay, what was that? And then, wait, what's that? Logged user. Oh, of course, I just returned null. Of course. This is what I expect, right? Cool. That's it. My first green test. Why not, right? And then name the test. How should I name the test? That's a question. Well, let's try. So, throws. Again, manager, what is the word? Who said that? Throws when no user logged it in.
Manager.
Testing me. Unit testing me. Now, I will show you an alternative, weird naming convention. Should. Again, Sandro Mancusov. People consider Sandro to be the descendant of Uncle Bob. The descendant. Initialization, because I'm running the wrong test. Run again. Green. Perfect. How does this read? Trip service should true when no user logged in. Good. Next one. Let's try to make it not fail.
We will use the
oldest design pattern in the world.
Yeah.
Prepared? Yeah. And we will say here that okay. I want this one to be okay. How many times did you name your test okay? Really? I mean, I have thousands of them. And I will return here a new user, which is not null, right? Rerun. I can just that. I should run all of them. All of the class. Okay, fails. Okay, fails. With null pointer. Oh. Do you know Chris de Burgh? He has a song. Lady in Red. It cuts your breath. Takes your breath away.
Yeah.
Null. So what do? You rapidly go. What the heck happened? Who threw it? And then you say this line through it. Okay, so what's wrong? Well, there is no user, my friend. The user that you passed in the method is null. Aha! It's easy. New user. Run. Professionals for that. Green. Perfect. But now we start thinking. We already had just enough garbage. So we should clean. The garbage piled up in the test. So let's clean this a bit. Where is the repetition? It's here. Extreme programming says to tolerate repetition 3 times. So let's play that card. Let's wait some more. Let's just be strong. Let's see. What does this do, really? It returns a list. A list. But this OK doesn't. It's trip list equals. Let's see, it returns, will it return me anything? By the way, this call here didn't give me anything, right? So let's make this to introduce a variable, let's say trips. And then let's see what's in that trips. The first thing I should do is to see what really happened. It's not different than null. I don't know what really happened there, I don't look here, right? I just say, if his friend, what is his friend? His friend is fourth. Okay, if I don't loop here at all, then this should be false. This should not happen. Right? This should not happen. And what should be returned here? Empty list. So I could say something like assert equals. And you will say, no, assert dot. But I will say, no, press control space twice. And assert equals. Twice, control space. Assert equals, and you say, I expect to be an empty list. Empty list. Control space twice from the collections. And I will say, if you just compare zero with the trips.size, many things can happen. What if it fails? Can you imagine the failure? Expected zero was one. What does that tell you? Nothing. So I wouldn't test the size of the collection, but instead I would test the entire collection, empty list compared with trips together. In case this fails for some reason, and I will do some horrible thing. I will introduce here a bug. I will mutate the production code to see that this really failed, because I did an assertion. Never trust tests that you never saw failing, never. So I will manually add here. I will do mutation testing. Oh my god, mutation testing at 10 p.m. Just trip list dot add of new, new trip. Okay. I'm just mutating the test in the production code, touching the holy things to see it failing, and it failed. And look how beautiful it is. You should have fast go there and implement. Oops. Sorry. And have a nice distance to string. Okay? But at least you could see the details of the two string of the trick, which is good in real life situations. I saw the test failing, I revert the change in production, and see it green again. And now I trust this assertion that I will, of course, try to static import And it's starting from here, thank you. Okay, so we have some more code to fix, but then while reading this code, we saw this.
And let me see.
Okay, this is the third case we could write. Multiple possible ways of doing it. Let's jump for the third one. Let's be strong today. This is Bulgaria, right? So let's do this too. So is what should this? How should I name this? If okay, two. Good one. Yeah. I have this actually. I have technically a slide for that. What do you do when you don't find a good name for a method? Come on, where are you? Second? There you go. You choose a Welsh one. It is a train station, my friend. So let's do that for just for fun. Let's, okay, two, and then let your cat walk the keyboard. Why? Because you will be ashamed to push it, right? It will scratch your eyes, you will bleed. When... Okay, so then what should happen for this to be true? And now you are, you notice how we are digging in the implementation. Superficially, and then we dig, 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 dig. How can we make this happen? You need this friend to be set true. Who sets it true? Well, I guess you, basically you iterate over the friend, and then you say friend equals. And if there is a friend in the list of friends of the user passed in as a parameter, which is equal to the logged user, and then it is true. Okay. Okay, I can do this, come on. So the user that I passed in, this is how it feels, right? This is detailed psychological analysis of legacy code testing first. And then this user that I passed in, this one, I will make it as a variable. It's like a variable, thank you. And I will name it user. And then this user should have a friend. Oh. And this friend should be the same user which is logged in, right? Logged user, which is also a variable, of course. And this logged user should, poor fellow, let's be new. And this logged user should be returned from here. Right? Now, poke. Boom. Excellent. I will take great pleasure in seeing a new test failing. That's the way that it should happen. You should see failures. Laws, just like tests, are meant to be broken. The point is, depends on you. Oh, what's that? Well, it seems that you are calling find chips by user from a DAO. I see many young people here. Do you guys know, at least know what a DAO means? Yeah. DAO.
Data access object.
Of course, you know. Younger might have missed those times. DAO. DAO. The JavaScript? JavaScript? Just speak afterwards, please. JavaScript. So it fails. Why? Because we're putting a static method on a DAO. Oh my god. This is a static. Italic. Man, this is italic. Static. My god. Static. What can you do?
This fails,
of course fails. So what can you do here, really? Extract the method. So without selecting anything else, Control Alt M, it already says to extract this syntactic. Let's see what happens if I press. Let's extract this first. And I will say find trips. I don't know, some method name, which I will of course make this time protected. What do you feel when you see protected? I feel terror. Terror. This means someone hacks you. Someone hacks you. Pay attention. Hacks you. In this place, I should do what? I should do find trips should be overridden. But you notice how few keystrokes I type. Good. Now, what should this return? Well, return a new list, or I don't know, maybe empty list. We will see about that. Wait a second. Just bear with me. Now, where this path? Yes. But you know that be very attentive. Did you saw that this is, we never saw this assert being false. You realize that? It's just green. It broke from other reasons, but not from the assert. We never, can we make the assert fail? Well, let's try. How can we make this surface? Let's try the same trick. Let's add the drip list, add a new trick. Will it fail? Yes, it fails. I'm supported operation. Whatever, it fails. That's important. Okay, so basically, this test here, this receptacles, but you know what? I can't judge clear anymore because of the mess. Look at the mess that gathered here. This is more than enough garbage. More than enough garbage. So let's clean a bit things and then we will see clearly what happened, really. The first thing, can you see duplication here? A lot of it, of course. That's the point, okay? So let's refactor that. How? Well, one thing you see that you will instantiate get trips, this thing, you will instantiate over and over again, right? So what could you do? You could take this and make it a field, exactly. So trip service. And this will be trip service equals stock. And then this should be a sort of trip service, not quite a second one, right? And trip service. And then I could say then this should all be. Wait a second. If I delete this code, what will happen? Well, you see, the thing that I extracted up there is slightly different than this implementation, right? Why? It returns null. And this is a tricky part, folks. In this case, I needed to return me null. In this other thing, I needed to return me a user, right? How can I do this? Well, one way to do it is to define here, what? A what? A second method, no. Even better. Come on. User, log user. You see where I'm going? Equals by default null, let's say. And then this will return this. What should I say here? Null. What should I say here? New user. Yes. And then if they do this, I expect that if I. Where are you? My dear test. And then move it to the right, move it, split and move right. There you go. And then control F again, and I would like to see it passing, but there is a problem. Trips. What's with these trips? Trips. I was expecting this to be the call. I just missed that, okay? And now I run again. Trips. And it's great. Now, very attentive what we're doing. Here we are working at our parachute, right? We are waiting on our tests. This is our life insurance. We are working at it, we need to be very careful. But then, what's next? Could we extract the duplication from here too? Well, if we would like to do that, what would we need to do? We would need to override find trips also, right? So let's do this. I will copy this into the above. What was that? Did you saw that? Insane. Okay, and then put this here and return by default an input, which is true until now, it's okay, it shouldn't break because those other tests don't need that method to be called, they don't ever call that method, so then I could think that this can be replaced by trip service. And run. Fails. Why? Let's see. User not logged in. Interesting. User not logged in. What did I forget to do? No. What did I remove? What did I forget to do?
Line 37.
But let's analyze what we feel now. We have to do this. Why? Because we have at the top of the class some setup, some fixture, which forces all the tests to be coupled together. You feel this? Do you feel the cuffs on your hand? Okay. Good. Now, let's see what happens next. If I do this, then run again, and all green. But then let's look closer. What really happens here? Add friend, logged user. Logged user is new user. This is wrong. This shouldn't happen. I mean, what user? Is it true? I should be adding the friend, the logged user. Folks, when I delete this line, how to put it? Is this Now, when I find that there's something wrong here, can you spot the problem? It's very tricky, really. What's the problem? Get trips by user, return trips, and then I assert the list is empty. What am I missing, technically speaking? I'm missing a case that will check what happens when this find trips returns me some list with some values. I'm missing this. So, just when you notice that there's a missing case, you will create that case. Let's create another one, telling what? Return which trips? User's trips, return user's trips. If, when will it return the trips? When and only one, how can you read this? It returns the trip of the user if what? If the logged user is friend with someone in the list of, you know, if the logged user is one of the friends of the user passed in, right? God, feels like legacy code, right? So, returns user trips if logged user is friend with user. Perfect name. Now, how to put this? Let's try to make this test to be correct, this fixture. So there is the logged user, okay. There is user, okay, that I will pass in. Should be here the logged user as a friend, in which case I want to have some values here. What would you do here? Well, I would need some actual trips. I mean, some actual list of trips to be there. How will those trips be? How will those trips enter the tested code? By this find trips method. So then, why do I need to do? Here, for my new test, I don't need to return empty list. You realize that? I need to return some real list. So what would I do? I would say here, users trips. This is a field that I will define here, and I will say list of trips named users trips. Okay, and let's say that by default is this. This is a bit debatable if it's good or not to write like that. Now, what should I do down here? When if the load user is really the friend of the current user, I should do what? I should set this to be as list. 2 times control space as list of a new trip. Okay? This will effectively make the production code that I'm testing to receive here when it calls this, to receive this list that I've configured here. Do you realize that? It will give me that list. What's next? I need to assert this here. Do you follow? It's late, we have a beer, it's a legacy code, okay. But this is down here. So let's go green. Okay, so set the code. User strips and trips. Good, so we are equaling. And there's something in there. Good. Now, at this point, there is. Let's look again. Let's read again. What the heck happens? And let's put some names. So true when no user logged in. Good. What does this really do? Okay, it says logged user equals user. What does this really do? Well, technically speaking, it means that there is no friend, basically, right? There is no friend in the user's list, basically. Am I doing something wrong? No, this is okay. So this user doesn't have any friends in its list. So basically here, this never happens, right? Okay, so how to put this in words? Return what? Empty list. But folks, this is very tricky. This empty list comes from here. Returns empty list when user doesn't have any friends. Good. Now, because user doesn't have any friend, you can read it right here. No friends here. And this is empty list and this is fine. Good. How will I name this misery? Well, what is the difference between this and this test? You explored the code and you wrote the test while also understanding the production code. And you ended up with 2 tests. What are these really testing? This says that it turns user strips is locked, user is friend with user. Isn't it doing the same thing? So then, technically speaking, how to put it? Wait a second. I want to prove a bug in a test. I want to prove that this test has a bug. Can anyone spot the bug? There's a bug in the test. Let's see if you find it.
You're not calling add friend from the field, you're doing it from
the I'm not calling add friend. I'm calling add friend at the user, but I'm not giving it the parameter. So again, men, the color do matter.
It's a local variable.
My God, you have a bug in the test. Can we prove the bug? Can we prove the bug? Can we? It's tricky. How can we prove that this is really a bug? Well, one way to do it is this. This is the time where I should commit, really. This is the place where I would commit. Now, I would say that the user strips are this, and I will expect the same to come back. True? Failed, although the production is correct, so you check it, but the test is wrong. Super subtle. Very few developers are able to prove, to see. Not to mention that you need to doubt your own parachute, your own unit test, right? And then prove that it's wrong. Now, technically speaking, since this is kind of wrong, I could put here the field by just wiping out this line. This one. Okay? I wipe this line, and this becomes with color, what color is this? Brown, I don't know. So colors do matter. Okay, good. So it's all fine and nice. Now, we build ourselves quite of a structure. But tell me, are we done? Well, this is just the beginning, my friends. We did a lot of trade-offs here. Look at the misery of this. Just imagine you will be maintaining such a unit test. Now, for those of you more into mocking, this could be replaced with a spy. Don't tell the others. But because this is evil, whatever, however you put it. Now, let's get rid of this. How can we get rid of that? Why did we have to do this? Why? Because this code is a coupling of your production code. This is what made testing so hard. How can we solve the coupling? Let's start with this one. How can we resolve the coupling? Think. Injection, of course. That's why containers prevailed over static get instance. Because singletons are very hard to test. What I will do is very simple. Kill it from here and say user session. What is a user session? It's a field. User session must be a field. And let's make it final, okay? User session. Good. If it's final, it deserves a constructor. There you go. I have a constructor. When I construct this now, I need to pass in a user script. This time, let's take out the real guns, right? So let's get real for once. So, so we have Mockito in place, so we will do what? We will have a mock here. We will say private, then we will say user session. And then we will pass the user session inside. Okay. Then, if we change this in this manner, okay, let's see. Did we broke anything? Let's see. Everything is still fine because I'm still hacking this method, actually this method. How can we replace this even further? Well, instead of faking the method, of overriding the method, we might let the call propagate to the user session, which is now suddenly a mock. Okay? Mockito will mock every field marked with @mock, and we will automatically do here equals mockito.mock of user session. Something like that, user session. Yeah, you get the point. This does it automatically for me. Who does it? The runner. Now, the user session thing I could use. Now, what should this test return when control space once more Mockito when user session when dot get logged user, then return. What should we return? Return. Should return null, because this is what was before, null here. Okay, null for you. Good. Test. But actually, if I run the test now, I'm not testing anything. I should take off this part here. I should kill this. So I will have to do a big bang in my tests now. I will comment this and make it work. It's an inevitable at this point. What should this method, the second one, behave? What should this method return on when I ask the user? Cool. Actually, let's stick with the fields for a second. I'll just return here logged user, right? What should happen here? Logged user. I'm faking the method and making it return the same thing whenever I call it. Everything is run, it is red. Unexpected exception. User not logged in, but with null pointer. Where the heck is the null pointer coming from? Interesting. Let's dig. Get logged user. Get logged user here, apparently, ended up with a null. Why? Tricky question. Even for the more advanced, the more experienced with Mockito.
Because the actual mocking is not happened yet.
Because the actual mocking has not happened yet. Who will make it equals new mock? Mockito runner. When will it do it? After instantiation. When is this happening? Right during the instantiation of the test class. How to fix it? Slower. Yeah, that's the end, but slower. Let's make it before. Before will happen after the instantiation. In the before, public void initialize. And I will say here that this assignment happens inside the trip the before here. Run again. After the mocks were injected, all green. This is the tricky step, tricky part. Then, taking baby steps further, what should we do next? Let's private here. We got rid of one of the hacked methods. Good. One, there's one left. And since this method doesn't really do anything, I will just inline it back. Inline. Fixed. Now, we have this left. What should we do about this one? This is a static method. Anything that was static tomorrow can become instance. Do you agree on that? The other way around is not true, but anything that was static can become instance tomorrow. So I will make it instance. And technically, normally, I will submit myself. Achoo! Achoo! So the point is, now it's an instance method. Since I need an instance, I should do what? Injecting. Why? Because of tests. So, private final user, the user, the, how is it called? User trip, what is it called? Trip down? Yeah, trip down. And since this is a field, final field, needs to be set in the constructor. Thank you. And alt enter driven developer. And I have for you a poetry. When it's red, yellow, blue, or gray, our dental will save your day. Poetry. This is poetry. So trip down is to also be a mock. Trip down. Good. And then if this is a mock, I should be returning these user trips everywhere, returning user trips. So, without further thinking, I will say user trips, trip down. Though when they call get trips, how we call it? Find by trips by user. What user? Any object for this purpose. For now, any object. Any object. Any object. There you go. Okay, static import, please, here, static import, okay? Then return trips, user trips. This is what should be returned everywhere. When should also be important. And there we go, that's what should happen every time. Wait a second, why am I copy-pasting? Stop. Before, that's why we have before, right? So let's move this here. We run, and there's one little thing missing. This should be on the small t. Small t. All green, but not yet there. Remember, we are still faking it. So comment this out, run again. Almost right. What's wrong with this one? Well, this will cause us a lot of headaches, friends. Because this is actually very tricky. This method here, return user trips if logged user error, this one, there's an interesting thing going on. What do I do here? I rewrite the field. When? Too late. The method getTrips was already programmed to return user trips. What was the value at that time? Empty list. Oops. What should you do? And this is a price you need to pay for the before. You sometimes, 5%, 20% of the test won't be happy with what you programmed for all of them. So in that case, you will need to change your mind. There, reassign it to be as list. Get the point? Reprogram the mock. Reteach the actors to answer in a certain way. Almost there. Come on, one more shot. So, now let's clean up. This is no longer needed to subclass it dynamically, no longer needed. Since we just inject stuff in a trip service, technically, this can be what?
Inject mocks.
And then this does it automatically for me, injecting through the constructor, all fields, all private fields, all setters, doesn't care, they copy pieces from Spring. So technically speaking, this will make trip service be automatically injected with all the mocks that, all of these are mockitos, my friends. Mockito everywhere, right? But this still works, initialize, good. Logged user, good. But now technically, this logged user, does it make sense to keep? I'm not really sure. For instance, user strips doesn't pay to keep because I had to reset it downward. So what I could do is to inline it everywhere, meaning put empty list here. There we go. Let's see if it breaks anywhere. Yes, it breaks. I need the list here. Okay, buy yourself a list. And guess what? As list. Come on, who does this list? Static import, come on. And then users trips equals. Okay, it's a list. Good. What's next? Let's see. Reading again. Logged user. Okay, logged user. Logged user sometimes. Good. But is it really necessary to be a field? No. The list you share with the neighbor test, the better. So why not kill the kid? And just alt enter driven development, friends, nothing more. No, it's red, so alt enter. It's red, so alt enter. Good. No problem, it's easy. And what's next? Let's see. Use logged user equals user, when logged user, the return logged user, and then user equals user, and user and friend logged user. It's quite fair. And then trips return. Okay, good. Well, enough about polishing the test. Let's move to the production code. How can we, now that we have a strong unit test, how can we simplify it? Well, tell me. 5 more minutes and we're done. How can we simplify this map? Very simple.
Invert
this. Invert this. Flip. Take the else part away. What next?
Use a stream.
Yes, you mean like this?
Yeah.
What happened?
Idea.
But folks, these are safe moves, really. I did not touch anything but alt enter, and that's it. Technically, I could have done that without the tests. In there, I won't miss these refactorings. Then, yes?
First, you can remove the trip list from
above. The what? The?
Remove the initialization of trip list from above.
Here, right?
Because it will be empty in any case except if it's friends.
Okay. Let me see if I can do all alt enter. Not yet. But what should I return here, always?
Entry list.
Entry list. There's a slight difference between the two, but entry list is good enough. Good. Not this, but it's also good, but something. What should I return? Oh, it's grayed out. Wait a second. Remove. Good. Alt-enter. I'm not doing anything else, just doing that. I missed something. Alt-enter. Remove. That's a tricky dialect to explain. I will just keep it. Hey, wait. Then, no, remove it, okay, but what should I do here?
Don't.
At which place I better bet the health test, right? Green. You are safe, my child. You are safe. This, by the way, and I didn't tell you not to scare, this was the toughest, the hardest, the most hardcore option, really. Because it calls for many, many things. Then wait, his friend. Let's extract this, it's too long. Let's make a method. How would I name this method?
His friend.
His friend with manager. Aha, so it was you. Okay, then, what next? Where should this method be placed? Better than here. Think.
In the user
class. In the user class. F6, move. Would you like to move it in the user class? Again, we are thinking bad words. What the heck happened? I don't like narcissism, so I will inline the gap here. Okay, so then what happened here? What's left? This can be safely. Wait, what a second. Move join declaration. Good. This can be inline. And then what's next? This, yeah, technically speaking, I could kill the variable and repeat the call 2 times. It's very fast, who cares, right? So inline. Then tell me, does this method really pay off being here? No. Inline. Perfect. That's it. 4 or 5 lines of code. Right? This was actually hidden underneath that thing that we saw, right? Way super easy and way more readable. But now, just as a final idea about this, what the heck happened? There is one particular slide that needs to be discussed about this exercise. Just a conclusion. What happened? We started testing from the outward of the code. You realize that? We started testing the most accessible code. And we dug ourselves our way inside the production code by understanding progressively each indentation, digging in. This is how it felt, right? So we will start testing from the outer of the code. But when you will refactor, you will start refactoring the most deep one, the most deep code. You will start from there refactoring. So the point, my main point here is that you will start testing legacy code from outside, building scaffolding unit tests while also understanding the code as you read it, right? Well, I kept a little bit more than expected, sorry. That was it actually. Thank you so much for staying so late with me. And if you still are in the mood for a beer, I'll be here. Thank you.